K98 Talk is expanding its lineup for 2015. This means we are expanding our advertising base. Whether you're a startup trying to push through to the next level, or an established business trying to supplement your advertising budget, web-based advertising is a solid investment. Thanks to Talk's newest partnership with TuneIn Radio and instant access to our sister station, K98 FM, we give you worldwide access at a reasonable cost. Interested parties should email us at sales@k98fm.com.
In these uncertain economic times, you've got to do whatever you can to save money. One of our biggest expenses can be our cars, especially when unexpected repair bills hit. Not anymore. If you own a vehicle with less than 130,000 miles, is less than 12 years old, has a warranty about to expire, or even no warranty at all, you could stop paying for car repairs. Roadside assistance, towing, and rental coverage are all included. Don't wait for the next repair. Make one free call right now to see if you qualify. If your vehicle is less than 12 years old, has less than 130,000 miles, even if it's out of warranty, paying for car repairs can become a thing of the past. Call us right now and get your car protected before your next repair bill hits. Get protection and no more repair bills. Call 800-696-1030. Again, 800-696-1030. That's 800-696-1030. 800-696-1030.
Joe had huge problems with the IRS.
I knew it was coming. I hadn't filed taxes since 1990.
All the IRS letters coming in added up to a nightmare.
To get up to like $68,000, my heart started beating fast. It's like, there's no way, man. I mean, I ain't going to be able to do this.
Then they stopped his paycheck.
So that's when I started making phone calls and found U.S. Tax Shield.
U.S. Tax Shield went to work immediately.
They just took the bull by the horns. What blew my mind is he called the IRS right then and there.
So why is U.S. Tax Shield A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau? Joe knows.
They saved me a ridiculous amount of money.
If you owe more than $10,000 to the IRS or state, choose the company Joe chose, U.S. Tax Shield.
It was the best decision I made. U.S. Tax Shield is the way to go. Life is good. Thank you, Lord.
Call 800-471-3287.
U.S. Tax Shield. Boo-rah. Yes.
800-471-3287. 800-471-3287.
Game on, where progressives fear us and rhinos tremble. Welcome to the political jungle. I'm JD.
This is Stacey. No one is safe. No one is spared.
Lock up the children.
And the old folk.
Welcome to the world of libertarian conservatarians.
That's right, baby. The radio show is so good that we know that one listener actually has an ear up against the radio and a meth spoon up the nose. Monday night, December 8th, 2015, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. JD and Stacey here for that Game On and that K98 Talk. Welcome back to all our political freaks, geeks, and back alley sneaks. Everybody within the sound of my voice right now, you know what to do. You get over to that K98talk.org, get in that chat room, say hello to Stacey, say hello to the best, smartest, nakedest, drunkest, craziest chat room audience in the radio listening business. Jam pack hour tonight, kids. The Donald said, non mas Muslims. Press and the establishment.
Muslims.
President establishment heads explode. Everyone else running for president goes full Obama and says, love those Muzzies, baby. Judge Jeanine gets it right. Write in that Judge Jeanine for president, baby, because I've had it with everybody. New parody song tonight by that Third Rail Ramblers, brought to you by that Beaker O'Donovan and that Two Cynic Al. We got Red Fox tonight and more. Remember, guys, we're not just here Tuesday night, 9 p.m. Eastern Standard. We do it again live Thursday night for another edition of Game On with the best lead in Thursday night radio, that Bell River with that Whom the Bell Tolls, baby, on that K98 Talk. Stacey and I live again Sunday. Sunday, 11 a.m. Bloody Marys and broadsheets, your cure for that mainstream media hangover. Friday nights, 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, drive time, WNJC, 1360 a.m. We are proud to be Yahoo Sports' new lead-in on the Friday drive time. Rick Wilson coming up if Stacey ever gives him a call after the show, kids not doing it. You get over to Spreaker.com, hashtag JD and Stacey, J-D-A-N-D-S-T-A-C-E-Y. Find out a catalog of everything we've been doing here with that Ricky Diggy Tavi Rick Robinson. And we didn't forget about you. It was so cold out this morning when JD went out to get the ice off his car. I don't want anybody to forget that. K98 Talk Cruise coming up hopefully this spring to you, baby. Good evening, darling. How are you?
I'm great. How are you? I didn't realize the internet connection from prison was so awesome.
Oh, it wasn't prison. See, the way it's going to work, I know that you haven't been filled in on this. Before we actually get locked up and start doing jailhouse radio, we have to get evaluated.
I hate this place. Nothing works here. The medications don't work. I've been here for 7 years.
You know, I love this radio audience. I looked up, left eye, chat room monitor, and I see ice beaners.
Nice.
That's okay, because evidently Donald Trump has given us the opportunity to bring you an hour of racism radio, baby. We're going to go through all of the news on that today. JD and Stacey are going to give you their take. But before we go into that, and before Stacey and I catch up a little bit and start into the program, we're going to take this over both segments. We have a bunch of audio for you guys. As I said, we have, you know, Stacey and I are so lucky. This show started about a year ago. You know, it really came out of the gate as a friends and only, you know, experiment. And here we are less than a year later. We have a whole bunch of syndicates and affiliates. We're up on 1360 AM on that WNJC. And we actually have people that have just been such friends of the show. And, you know, we have these writers and these musicians, and their parody songs are great. And that's that Third Rail Ramblers, and you guys are in for a real treat tonight. But before we get started, I want to cover what I thought to my mind was a more important news event than even what's come out of the news cycle in the last 24 hours. And this broke at about 4:28 p.m. On Sunday, Eastern Standard Time. And basically what that was hold on a second, baby. What was that? Beating those New Jersey softball Giants in that overtime 23-20.
I bring nothing to the table.
Oh, my God. I mean, all it takes to win the NFC East this year is a 2-14 record, and Eli Manning is just like,
it's over, Johnny. It's over. Nothing is over. Nothing. You just don't turn it off.
Well, we'll see if they... We'll see if they're able to pull it together. I better bell myself.
I don't know how you do an entire hour of radio when you are not speaking to your co-host.
Let me tell you something. I have enough audio and news that this would be the show I can get away with it, so you might want to stay on the line tonight.
Oh, all right.
Okay, so the news that, and this is a commentary in and of itself. I don't know if it's a commentary on the media. I don't know if it's a commentary on human nature. I'm not sure what it's a commentary on yet, but you have the Paris attacks a few weeks ago, and you're coming off the heels of the San Bernardino shooting just within the last several days here. Now, the president won't say it, but the FBI has. It's Islamic terrorism. And Donald Trump today.
Oh, and now daddy's on the watch list. I mean, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And basically the whole, everybody knows it's all.
Oh, durka.
They're fighting over that poor baby. I mean, that poor baby just breaks my heart.
The baby itself breaks my heart. I am cynical enough at this point that I've read some reports about whether or not it literally existed as a prop. And these people are not humans. They're savages. They're animals. I said it. Anybody who missed it. These people are not humans. They're savages. They are animale. So what I'm saying is so what takes over the news cycle from this? Okay, with two terrorist attacks in a few weeks on two Western powers, and what takes over the news cycle are Donald Trump's comments, and you've all heard them. We're going to play them here for you in a second. They're about 30 seconds long. This 30-second sound clip is what has the punditry set, the establishment, the left, the right, everybody in between, all up in arms. Anybody who listens to this program knows that I came out of the box. I kind of stayed agnostic. I have not been a big Donald Trump fan for a variety of different reasons. But you have the president of the United States who, with the attack in San Bernardino, and basically his entire presidency, he just leaves a vacuum of leadership. No direction, no anything, at a time when the American public is looking for some. So as Obama hides and goes to fundraisers, Donald Trump, possibly because a poll had just come out with Ted Cruz ahead of him in some states. But these were Trump's comments. That was not Trump's comments. That is the parody song that also has Trump in it. Hold on. This one, Trump's comments.
Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States until our country's representatives can figure out what the hell is going on.
My apologies. It was 16 seconds with 14 seconds of applause. Mm-hmm. That singular comment set the news afire, set social media afire, set the punditry class afire, set everyone afire. You know who it did not set afire? Do you know who it did not set afire? Every other Republican presidential candidate.
Well, now, here's just, again, a little perspective, okay? If you listen to Obama's speech on Sunday night and you watch the after shows, okay, Marco Rubio was very clear in his commentary after Fox. He was not kind. He was very specific about the kinds of controls we had to put in. Mike Huckabee, very clear. Even Lindsey Graham, who's very comical, was very clear. Carly Fiorina, very clear. Some of these people have put out very specific plans and policies about how they would like to see refugees and other things taken care of, how they would like to structure our military presence to relieve Russia of its leadership position in the Middle East and also attack the problem of radicalized Islam, ISIS, in the Middle East. And for some reason, okay, rather than staying absolutely trained on what is wrong with the democratic approach to this, and God, there was so much wrong with Obama's speech, all of a sudden, the entire news cycle turns into a reaction, and everybody's got to have a freaking reaction to Donald Trump's 15 minutes worth of, or 15 seconds worth of comment.
And this goes back to what I've been saying, because I have an absolutely 180-degree different take on this than you do. I know that a lot of people think that Donald Trump has wrought havoc into the GOP primary process. To my mind, what Donald Trump has exposed, just like any great quarterback and receiver combination in the NFL or in college can expose weaknesses in an opposition's defense, Donald Trump has exposed how feckless and weak the rest of the candidates are who are running for this office. Because you want to know something? What you just said, Stacey, the candidates, you know who they spoke to? They spoke to you. They spoke to Washington, D.C. They spoke to the journalists in New York and in Los Angeles and Miami. And what I'm referring to are the very thought-out, wonkish, to somebody who is a politico, rational, bland approaches at a time when this entire country is bleeding visceral emotion and looking for leadership. Not one of those candidates on Sunday could identify that. Not one of those other Republican candidates. And please, before I start getting Before I start getting emails and phone calls about this, this is not an advertisement for Donald Trump. In my mind, what this has done, this has exposed and confirmed the fact that Republican candidates do not know how to politic. Do you want to know why those comments that Donald Trump just made seized the news cycle? Because they spoke to people and it woke them up, whether they were pissed off about the comments or whether they said, you want to know, Jack? Right on. Go ahead. We have to stop this nonsense. It emoted people and got reactions. All of those other candidates that you just referenced spoke before Donald Trump did, and not one of them, either personally or through their consultants, had the foresight to tap into that kind of emotion. Now, as a politico, you might not like that emotion. You might think emotion is gauche, but unfortunately, the majority of people who walk in to vote for presidents in a general election are not politicos. They're very busy people. And to my mind, what Donald Trump did in a vacuum of leadership, because you and I have had this conversation offline, you and I have had this conversation offline. There is a difference between what is right and what you should do and what is politically smart. Donald Trump, outside of some of his immigration policy, has not given specifics on very many things, and it drives people like me crazy, and it drives people like Stacey crazy, and it drives a lot of our audience crazy. But if I was a political consultant with the numbers that he continues to have, I would tell him, shut your mouth, bro. Until you start taking a hit politically, the smart thing to do is not go into specifics. Now, let this turn your stomach, but that's why President Barack Obama is a two-term president. Two-term presidents are rare in this society. That man got there by going, I'm going to change the oceans and $2,500 less and da-da-da-da-da. And again, what happened? The people on the Republican side couldn't tap into the angst and emotion and fear that existed in the American electorate, and we got Obama twice. We got Obama twice. Stacey, why are all of these other candidates? I will let Ted Cruz off the hook on this because I thought he had a good answer, or I thought he had the best answer of the bunch. But why can these candidates not tap into your average voter at the coffee shop, online at the bank, driving to their third job to pay their bills? Why can these candidates not tap into that?
Carly Fiorina spoke about complete government incompetence. People are terrified. We need real proposals to make the government competent to keep us safe. She said, overreaction, Trump. Underreaction, Obama. Obama attacks us on two-way. Trump is now attacking us on religion. Neither answer is palatable. The problems are endemic. And that, to me, is a stronger message than we're just going to do this, right? I think the plain speaking,
the polls,
you can do, you can do plain speaking. So if you look at what Ted Cruz said in his...
But the polls belie what you're saying. The polls belie what you're saying. You just use Carly Fiorina as an answer. You happen to know I like Carly Fiorina. I think,
but I'm saying she didn't knuckle under to political correctness.
But she also...
All I heard today was people knuckled under, do we got to love Muslims? That's not what I heard when I went and looked at these speeches.
It doesn't matter what you heard when you went and looked to these speeches as a tuned political ear. It's what the American public heard out of this cycle. All of these people had an opportunity to speak on this topic, and they did. You said it on Sunday. And you know what? People like us thought, hey, that was great. That was a good answer. That makes sense. That is not your average voter. Your average voter wants a story. Your average voter. You got Ron Fournier, who was on the show. Ron Fournier, the guy who headed up the Washington Bureau of the Associated Press, who was their White House correspondent for years. He'll tell you flat out he's one of the smartest people we've ever had on the show. He likes to vote for people he likes to have a beer with. Politics are not complicated. Why did the Tammany Hall system exist for so long with that corruption inside of New York City? Because New York City people love corruption? No, it was because they knew how to tap into what voters wanted to hear. And there was never a countervailing, opposition party or candidate on the other side that can do that. And through this election cycle, I'm seeing it time and time again. I don't care what Carly Fiorina said anymore. You want to know why? Because if you look at the poll numbers, neither do the voters. I don't care what Marco Rubio had to say on this anymore. Because you want to know why? He didn't tap into the voters. If you want to take a look at voters and who was tapped into in this, it was either people who support Trump or the sentiment. And again, I'm not advocating voting for Donald Trump. But what I am saying, is that the answers from some of the people on our side today are going to drive more people to Trump. Speaker Paul Ryan, who to my mind, and I said as much a couple of weeks ago, Stacey, when we were doing the show, we both did. Neither one of us thought that Paul Ryan was some lionized conservative icon, but you want to know what? He had the speaker's position. Man, it's great we got rid of Boehner. Ladies and gentlemen, this morning, Speaker Paul Ryan, otherwise known as John Boehner II.
Normally, I do not comment on what's going on in the presidential election. I will take an exception today. This is not conservatism. What was proposed yesterday is not what this party stands for. And more importantly, it's not what this country stands for. Not only are there many Muslims serving in our armed forces, dying for this country, there are Muslims serving right here in the House, working every day to uphold and to defend the Constitution.
Okay, that's enough of this idiot. And again, what he's saying is not incorrect, but Stacey, do you not think conservative, Republican, whatever you want to call it, primary voters, are tired of every statement about Islam or terrorism from the right starts with, listen, so everybody knows that our voters are a bunch of racist militia KKK member crackers. Let me say that we got to love ourselves some Muslims, baby, because only 25% of them, when they're polled worldwide, support Sharia law and this violence, which, if you run the numbers, is just north of 250 million plus. I know I went a little longer this, Stacey, but I'm passionate about this. Today scared me for the future of this country.
Cruz nailed it. I'm sorry, Cruz had the absolute right answer. He did not. He was not politically correct. He said, we are at war. We need to wage war. ISIS is the face of evil. Our commander-in-chief refuses to acknowledge or confront the enemy. His speech was so politically correct and blind that there is no strategy. He continues with a proposal to welcome Syrian refugees despite law enforcement cautions that says, we can't vet these people. This makes no sense.
Who they
okay?
Hate?
And he has a three-plank plan, and the reason I like it is because it takes the states into account.
How many angry
voters are there in the 30 states where governors have said, we don't want to participate in this program? The Refugee Resettlement Act actually has a component for state governments to participate in. Our federal government has completely wiped it away.
Right.
And what Ted Cruz is trying to do is a three-year moratorium on refugees from ISIS or Al-Qaeda-controlled areas. Protect the authority of the states. Governors can opt out of refugee resettlement if that's what they want to do. And the Expatriate Terror Act. If someone leaves and we confirm that they are fighting or committing jihad, they lose their U.S. citizenship.
Remember, I'm basically like the hair club for men here. JD is not just your co-host. He's also the producer. So I was just making the point that we have enough time to take. I want to spend some time on what Cruz said. There was no reason. We didn't need to jam it in. We're going to come back on the other side. I want to go over a little more what Stacey had just went into about Cruz, because as I had said, to my mind, I'm not going to say he hit the nail on the head. I thought his answer was the best. But. Because there's so much seriousness in the world, and because there's so much time for despair, baby, JD and Stacey have your cure for the holiday blues. Lay back right now and listen to the brilliant genius of Mr. Two Senegal and Mr. Beaker O'Donovan. This is perfectly timed, kids, for all of you who love that Mr. Grinch. And for those of you who think that Trump might be ending the world, take a listen to some Mr. Trump.
You're a keen one, Mr. Trump. Your manners are genteel. You commit verbal malpractice when your lips they break their seal, Mr. Trump. You're as bad as Nana with xenophobic appeal. Quite bonkers, Mr. Trump. Your supporters lack control. Intellectual outliers are paid for Russian trolls, Mr. Trump. Behaviorally challenged and sycophantically stupid cornholes. A serpentine one, Mr. Trump. With a beastly writing style, you have all the cogent vision of a steaming compost pile, Mr. Trump. From a constitutional perspective, I'd take the steaming compost pile. Manipulating Mr. Trump with influence you have bought. You'd steal a family's castle for an effing parking lot, Mr. Trump. You're a wee pecker thin skin of cup school blowhard, egomaniacal drunk. About your daughter, Mr. Trump, you've really nasty thoughts. Amazing, even Jared didn't want to date his tot, Mr. Trump. Your mouth is a bawling crap heap, overflowing with the most pathetic assortment of rhetorical whining imaginable. Just ask Megyn Kelly from Fox. Run your jowls much, Mr. Trump. Your numbers need a bump. Your lead right now is dwindling. Your polling's in a funk, Mr. Trump. The three words that describe you best are as follows, and I quote, bitch, ass, punk.
You listen to the show because the world's about to end. We're going to make you laugh a little bit. JD and Stacey here on Game On K98 Talk, coming right back completely humbled by the Third Rail Ramblers, Two Senegal and Beaker O'Donovan. Here's a break.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
If you like your health care plan, you'll be able to keep your health care plan. This is the most transparent administration in history. Not even a smidgen of corruption.
Fact is, we had four dead Americans. What difference at this point does it make?
If you've got a business, you didn't build that.
The feeling most people get when they hear a Barack Obama speech, I felt this thrill going up my leg. I don't have that too often.
Steady.
It's time to hear the truth about America's biggest challenges. Ricky Robinson, host of America Off the Rails, will tackle the important issues facing America today as he tries to keep America from coming off the track. Get ready to hear the truth every Monday through Friday starting at 7 p.m. Eastern, 6 Central, here on K98Talk.com and the Spark Radio Network.
Are you conservative in a world of liberal?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're not alone. Hey, I'm Daniel Stafford, host of The Stafford Voice, and I'd like to invite you to tune in each Monday, 10 p.m. Eastern, where I'll break down the events of the week, and together we'll learn about how they affect you. So, sit back and get ready for the good, the bad, and the ugly of talk radio right here on K98 Talk.
From the Vikings of Norway to my home down south to Washington, D.C., I've been around. I've seen it all, and I've come out on top. You better beware, for all you know, the bell tolls for you. Enter the bell tower or watch your step. 8 p.m. Thursdays, K98 Talk.
One ear on the speaker, spoon up the nose. JD and Stacey back here on K98 Talk on Game On. Everybody right now within the sound of my voice, you know what to do. Get over to K98Talk.org right now. Get in that chat room. Get in that chat room. where Stacey, you know, when you do a radio show with a co-host, every once in a while you run into a topic where one person is really passionate and worked up, and that was me in the last segment. I'm usually in this for the lulz, and I was. And honestly, if you get in the chat room and scroll up one of Stacey's last answers, Stacey just took my 20 minutes of babble and summed up what I was trying to say in about a sentence and a half. It's perfect. Remember, guys, after the show, not during it, you get over to Spreaker.com, hashtag JD and Stacey, JDANDSTACEY. Find a catalog of everything we've been doing here with that K98 Talk. Not just live Tuesdays at 9, we do it Thursday live again at 9, 5 p.m. drive time, WNJC 1360 AM, serving that Philadelphia, Southern Jersey, Northern Delaware. Sunday morning, Rick Wilson, Spreaker, K98 Cruise, JETS. Welcome back, baby.
Hello.
Wow, that was a hell of a parody. But that's why you listen, that guy. That's why you listen to Game On. That's why you listen to Game On. You get the news, you get the clips, you get parody songs. In the third segment, we got 300 Puerto Ricans getting arrested for something. No, not 300.
No, 300 Puerto Ricans.
No,
just
don't give
one
it away.
Guy.
Don't give it away. Don't give it away. You're telling me with the people who listen to the show, I just teased that I'm going to do a story about 300 Puerto Ricans getting arrested. Actually, to tease that story would be like. El Twittero. I think that's a good tease for that segment, right? Oh, you still with us?
Unfortunately, it has shades of reality at this point. So,
oh, whatever. Okay. I want to. We're keeping this topic over into the totality of the second segment. And one of the things we want to go into is our Judge Jeanine's. Had a 5-point prescription that Stacey and I are going to break down. If we're going to make the next break, we're going to have to start that in a few minutes. But let's go back a little slowly into, and this was the title of the Blaze article you had sent me. Ted Cruz proposes 3-year ban on refugees from Islamic State. And that was basically the plan that you were kind of rushing into before the end of the break. Why don't you take a little more time and just go over those 3 points in case anybody missed it? Because I think they are very important, because I think Cruz did. Out of the rest of the pack, I thought he had the best answer.
He basically says there are 3 pieces of legislation that need to pass, and the first is a 3-year moratorium on refugees from ISIS or Al Qaeda controlled areas. He's very, very clear about the fact ISIS has told us exactly what they're going to do.
But
did it in Paris.
But wait, you're always talking about detail. There's an important detail in his statement. He said where ISIS or Al-Qaeda controls, quote, substantial amount of territory.
Mm-hmm.
When I read that, and the reason that I think that he understands the politics of this, or at least his campaign does, is I want you to think about. So here's the first plank that he rolls out. Do you think it's any coincidence that the first plank of his prescription says where the Islamic State or Al-Qaeda controls a substantial amount of territory? Where does the Islamic State and Al-Qaeda hold a substantial amount of territory? It's where the ISIS-controlled regions are right now, whether it's pushing mm-hmm. into Turkey, whether it's Syria. It's what they refer to as the caliphate, which is now greater than the size of the United Kingdom, where the president refuses to really bomb. I thought that was actually some kind of dog whistle, almost. It stuck out at me.
Well, and I mean, it was actually interesting because in Fiorina's response on O'Reilly to the actual speech, she said, where does everybody run off to when they're going to run off to ISIS? Raqqa, Syria. Let's get rid of it. They're not hiding. Let's take care of this.
This goes back to not bombing the Durka
oil
supply.
Durka.
So that, you know, we don't cause environmental catastrophe. You know JD's take on this, right? Send everybody to go see
Virgin.
Thank you, Scott. Mm-hmm. So second plank for Cruz.
Well, and he partnered with Greg Abbott to do this speech, and Governor Abbott definitely had some great commentary as well. He was one of the first governors to come out and tell Barack Obama, I'm not taking your refugees. I'm not. And they went through some very specific numbers as an illustrative. And, you know, I think Ted Cruz was going to do this press conference, whether Donald Trump made his statements or not. Ted Cruz didn't change his plans today because of what Donald Trump said.
No.
This had already been in the works.
But that goes back to, and, you know, it's one thing that we have said about Cruz when you take a look at his numbers. And what I find very interesting, and again, for those of you who battle, you know, what have become called Trumpkins or Trump bots on social media, when I live in an area that has pretty broad and strains Trump support in different strains. And what I do find from a lot of Trump supporters who are on the conservative, or say they're conservative and they're on the right, you know, you would really be surprised. And again, you have got to excise the social media white power supremacist trolling aspects. When you speak to a lot of Trump supporters, their second and third candidates will bowl you over. Ted Cruz is the second for a lot of them, Marco Rubio, Ben Carson. So Cruz, to my mind, and his campaign, it always, you know, I always get a kick out of how everybody wants to sleep on Cruz. I think you're absolutely right in what you said. I think that they understand, and they're in for a marathon, not a sprint. But I think just in the same way that we got lucky with Mr. Trump, I mean, we didn't get lucky with Mr. Trump. It's a brilliant song by Beaker now and the Third Rail Ramblers, where we got lucky. This hit us, and within what, Stacey? 36 hours, Trump makes this comment. The world says he's Mr. Grinch, and it's Christmas. And I think the same thing happened with the Cruz campaign. I think that this was set up no matter what, basically more to respond to the Syrian refugee crisis. But this is what I speak about the other candidates, Stacey. If the other candidates were playing a long game like Cruz seems to be, mm-hmm. wouldn't they be positioned to reap the benefits of good time? Here's my point. Ted Cruz reaps the benefit of good timing for something that his campaign had already strategized and set out. And to my mind, it sounded like the rest of the candidates are behind the news cycle racing to respond.
Well, I mean, I definitely think that Ted Cruz did a good job in this press conference of pulling in recent events. I mean, they were working on this prior to the shooting in San Bernardino, but he certainly had his ducks in a row in terms of how that related to this, you know, in terms of talking about refugees and visa programs, you know, one of the Paris attackers was a refugee. ISIS intent, they've told us what they're going to do. They want to kill Americans. Why would we not believe them? And, you know, one of the two in San Bernardino was here on a fiance visa. You know, it the three-year moratorium on refugees from ISIS or al-Qaeda-controlled areas, I think we also have to look at some of the visa processes. I think that's where Cruz missed it, but I don't think he was prepared for it from a legislative perspective because he'd been working on this ahead of time.
But that's where I think that's where I think the politics of it comes into this. What you're saying is intuitively right, but it's wonkish in the wake of Paris and a fresh terrorist attack here that the administration won't speak to and sends an FBI rep out to. I hear you.
Right. But I think his stance on it
matter how many terrorists were on the visa waiver program or whatever it was. People want an answer that equates to somebody tell me they're going to stop this.
Right. But I also think there were governors of 30 states. Okay, that's a majority of the ones in the U.S. who said, no, Obama, we're not going to take your refugees. They're elected by the citizens of those states. Their primary duty as governor is to protect the people in their state.
It is.
And
but then
this
again,
administration is disallowing them from doing that by bypassing them under the Refugee Resettlement Act. Ted Cruz is trying to preserve that.
I understand that. But again, that's more of an argument about wishful principle. Because again, if you're either a constitutionalist and a strict conservative, I'm not saying you, I'm saying, you know, either you're a constitutionalist or you're not. You know, this goes back to it being everybody viscerally wanting to say, yeah, people on a no-fly list shouldn't have guns. Wait a minute. Do you understand the no-fly list, how some people have gotten on there, the fact that there's no due process, etc.? But like we said on Sunday's show, politically, it was expedient for Marco Rubio to say, no, people on a no-fly list shouldn't have guns because your average person thinks that the only person on the no-fly list is a terrorist or somebody who's gone through some kind of due process
or
adjudication.
You went Barack Obama because Marco Rubio said that was absolutely ridiculous.
No. We spoke about this Sunday. We can pull the clip from Sunday's show. No. He broke it
His
down.
His speech after Barack Obama's thing said the no-fly list brought up the 72 DHS employees.
We talked about this. You want to know something? Keep talking because I have the clip. We played it Sunday. I put it in additional. So hold on. Let me pull Rubio's clip. While we're looking for that, do you want to start a little bit about Judge Jeanine so we can go into her prescription, which I actually thought was brilliant? Well, not brilliant, but I thought it was a prescription.
I mean, it's not a brilliant prescription, but what I like about it is I do believe, okay, there is a way to not be quote-unquote politically correct and at the same time be prescriptive, but also not be 100% offensive and come from a perspective. And I guess, you know, I'm not looking necessarily for a Jeanine Pirro-like statement from Donald Trump, but I would like to hear a little more perspective on exactly what he's talking about, because the blanket statements, and I'm sorry, you know, I feel as a conservative that Donald Trump's remarks and what he has done since the very beginning of his campaign, despite the grain of truth that might be what he is saying, okay, has painted every single person in the conservative movement with that huge brush that the Democrats love to paint us with.
No, he doesn't. No, he doesn't. Those responses by Paul Ryan and the rest of the candidates do. I mean, you want to look. And again, I say they're rejecting that brush.
No, it is
excuse making to let the Republican establishment and these candidates off the hook. The reason these key people are always going to suck at campaigning is because the right is always going to be looking for an excuse of why that person shouldn't have won. You know, I had this conversation with somebody today who was talking about the stupidity of the American people and the fact that Obama could get elected twice, and Americans are so stupid because Mitt Romney was right, and didn't they know? Yeah, people intuitively knew that Mitt Romney, but you want to know why Mitt Romney isn't president? Because Mitt Romney was a bad presidential candidate, damn it, that's why. It goes back to the fact that before this process started, I liked Rand Paul. I would have liked him to go somewhere. But it is not my job to sit here and defend a feckless campaign. I love Carly Fiorina. I think she's doing better. I think she makes some good points. But I can't sit here and let the excuse that the reason that the rest... You want to know something? Ronald Reagan, we speak about it all the time. You don't speak to the media. You speak over the media, through the lens, and to the American people. And I'm sorry, but I cannot sit here. And in my opinion, Donald Trump did not ruin Christmas. Eric Erickson has been pounding the table since 2008 about the circle-jerking, just cash-and-checks nature of the Republican consultancy for politicians at the presidential level. And I think if we continue to say, well, in this cycle it was because this, and in this cycle it was because of this guy, and in this cycle the evangelicals didn't like the fact that ba 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 ba, it keeps, everybody says, where's the next Ronald Reagan? Maybe we don't have candidates like that because we don't demand it of them. That's just the way that
I'm saying, when I look at the press and the news cycles that have gone on since the middle of the summer, and I've thought this, and I have not seen such an awesome expression of it until Noah Rothman's article today. Every time the Democrats get in trouble, whether it's Hillary with Benghazi, whether it's Hillary with her emails, whether it's Barack's disastrous speech, Donald Trump comes out with something that completely turns the news cycle on its ear, and that ticks me off.
You know what? It should tick you off. And you know why it should tick you off? It's not because Donald Trump upended the news cycle. It's because when this started, Stacey, what was the big joke when this started? That it was Donald Trump and the other 436,937 and a half people, because Lindsey Graham's a half a candidate. He's a half of something.
Three simple words. I am gay.
But we would say that there were 436,937 and a half candidates running for president. And you're going to tell me that it's Donald Trump's fault for monopolizing the news cycle? You're telling me the other 436,937 and a half candidates. Maybe that's our problem, Stacey.
I'm saying that when you have a polarizing candidate and people who hate him are going to turn in every bit as much as people who love him, the media runs on ratings, and we know this.
And people who hate him tune in
to see what he's going to say just as much as people who love him.
You just made my point for me. The media runs on ratings. Barack Obama, young, dash, going to do this. Oceans, $2,500, healthcare. Hillary Clinton, first woman this. Donald Trump. Celebrity.
Hillary Clinton doesn't get those ratings. She's not exciting.
It doesn't matter, Stacey. You said it's ratings driven. Our candidates can't bring the ratings, and it's a shame. We do not have time for the Judge Jeanine clip. I think it's a 5.5-minute clip. She's got 5 prescriptions in it. Maybe we'll tweet it out or maybe we'll carry it over into Thursday. I really want you guys to hear it. Before we head out to break, though, Donald Trump's been a little pissed about being called a nativist. He's giving a press conference right now.
I would like to direct this to the distinguished members of the panel. You lousy corksuckers, you have violated my Fargan rights. This salmon-unbatching country was founded so that the liberties of common patriotic citizens like me could not be taken away by a bunch of Fargan ice holes like yourselves. Thank you very much.
If one of our candidates did that, Stacey, everybody would pay attention and they got ratings. I don't think we solved the problems of the election, but I honestly thought that was one of the best discussions that we've had in a long time. All right, coming back, segment three. It's what you've all been waiting for, nastiness of the world. Something about 300 Puerto Ricans getting arrested. JD and Stacey, K98 Talk. The show's so good, the show's so good, the show's so good that we know how serious it is. We make sure that you want to laugh. I hired. What do they call those people? The witch doctors, the people who do the seances. What the hell are they called? Mediums? Is that what they call them?
Sure.
Okay, Red Fox from the grave.
Let me get my cigarette fresh. I smoke and drink. A lot of you don't drink, no smoke. Some people here tonight, they don't eat butter, no salt, no sugar, no lard, no biscuits, no gravy with onions in it. Because they want to live. They give up that good stuff. Neck bone, pigtail. You're going to feel like a damn fool laying out the hospital dying from nothing.
JD and Stacey, K98 Talk. Laughter's the best medicine, baby. Otherwise, you kill yourself. Coming right back.
Hey, everybody, this is Jason, host of According to Me. I'd like to invite you to check out my show. It's a two-hour show that lasts 60 minutes in...
Listen, I hate to interrupt, but one thing I can do is read off a script. Just say, let me be clear a lot. It works.
President Obama, I can handle this. It's a radio promo. I'm not green. I've done this before.
Did someone say green?
Now, Al Gore is here. Listen, I'm just trying to record a radio promo. Do you mind?
Now, do you say good things about me on the show?
No, not at all. But if it makes you feel any better, I rip on Republicans just as much.
The AM radio frequencies give off very high levels of radiation.
Look, my show is on the internet, which you invented. I mean, can I just do my promo?
I got a pen. I can veto that, you know.
I know you got a pen. It's not a law. It's a radio promo. Listen, just listen to my show. Barack Obama and Al Gore hate it, so you're going
to
love it.
Here's an executive order. Don't listen to a show. He doesn't like me. He's racist. And he doesn't recycle either.
That's it. I'm done. It's According to Me, Wednesdays, 10 p.m. Eastern, right here on K98 Talk.
This show good, this show good.
Wondering why you're up early with us on a Sunday morning making a cocktail? News lately got you drinking? Hung over from the mainstream media by Sunday? We are, and we got you covered.
We sure do. We got your hangover cure for those weekly news blues. So sit back, top off your mimosa, and add some Baileys to that coffee.
Take a match to your copy of the New York Times. Light, funny, and oh yeah, news with booze.
And a lot of laughter.
Welcome to Bloody Marys and Broadsheets. If it's Sunday, it's Bloody Marys and Broadsheets.
We're your cure from your weekly news hangover.
We will never fully understand what we've asked of our military service members or their families, asking them to put themselves in harm's way, to endure it all. But we do understand that it's our turn, our duty, to keep them secure for the rest of their lives. Wounded Warrior Project long-term support programs help our most severely ill or injured veterans live independently, at no cost, for life, so that they might stand at ease. Join us at findwwp.org.
K98 Talk is expanding its lineup for 2015. This means we are expanding our advertising base. Whether you're a startup trying to push through to the next level, or an established business trying to supplement your advertising budget, web-based advertising is a solid investment. Thanks to Talk's newest partnership with TuneIn Radio and instant access to our sister station, K98 FM, we give you worldwide access at a reasonable cost. Interested parties should email us at sales@k98fm.com.
Welcome back, JD and Stacey, starting Revolution Radio with Game On here on K98 Talk. Everybody within the sound of my voice, get over that K98talk.org. Get in that chat room. Say hello to Stacey. Somebody cheer her up, man. She's standing on the ledge. God, the breaks are where I go. I like to look in there and laugh. I look in the break room. It's not ending. That's why we do this. You know why we do this? We do this so that these asshats listen and it doesn't happen. Remember, kids, we're not just live Tuesday nights, 9 p.m. Do it again Thursday, 9, leading Bell River, whom the bell tolls. Friday, live, 5 p.m., the WNJC 1360 AM, serving that Southern Jersey, Philadelphia, Northern Delaware. K98 Talk Cruise. So I don't think that we solved the problems of the day, but I honestly think that discussion that we just had was one that needs to be had. I really do. I think that.
But it's not going to be had.
It's not up to the party, Stacey. It's up to the people and to the voters. You know, you made a good point in the chat room about getting the government that we deserve. We also get the candidates that we deserve. Because I think that we're settling into a place that we're settling into the best of the bad. And that's unacceptable. I don't care.
We've been doing it for the last 12 years, 14, 16 years, okay? It's become the lesser of two evils, all right? And I will honestly say, and I'm making a public declaration on the radio tonight, if it comes down to Trump v. Hillary, I will go third party or leave the top line blank because I will not take responsibility for either one of them in the overall Oval Office. Just
won't. Fantastic. There's some openings on current TV. You'd make a great liberal television host. From the Associated Press, this is the song that we were going to tease with the... News from the Associated Press. Keep your ear in the straw. San Juan, Puerto Rico. A Puerto Rican man accused of... And now, for those of you in New York, this does not mean someone who lives in the Bronx. A Puerto Rico man was accused of creating 300 Twitter accounts to harass people online, has been arrested in the first case of its kind for the U.S. territory, authorities said. Man, does this... What is this? Art imitates life. The island's Justice Department said 27-year-old Omar Falcon Torres. Falcon. Is suspected of operating under the name Madea Butt for 2 years. He faces charges include stalking, misappropriation of identity, and intimidating witnesses, in part by sending people, quote, violent sexual imagery, unquote, and using violent language, authorities said. The judge in September issued a warrant for Falcon, who was arrested late Monday at a relative's house in the central mountain town of Comerio.
Officials $180,000 bail.
That. Tell the pretty lady what she's wrong. Something tells me.
And nobody's talking about it until December 21st.
On the 21st preliminary hearing. But here's the whole thing. I think that this is funny as hell, but they have got to leave out. This guy has got to have a list of priors a mile long. Do you know how high a bail bond of $180,000 is in Puerto Rico?
Look at what Puerto Rico's going through. They're just trying to cover their losses.
300 Twitter accounts.
That's just somebody with way too much time on their hands.
I hate this place. Nothing works here. The medications don't work. I've been here for 7 years.
Oh, my God. Be careful in prison. He's going to get in one of those work programs.
How'd you like to mow my lawn? Huh?
There you go.
Okay, so we made Game On history. We made JD history today. I actually printed out a story from physics.org. New U.S. space mining law to spark interplanetary gold rush. This is how bad Obama has destroyed this country. People now think the economy is never going to come back around. Do you know what the smartest scientists on the planet are doing? They're looking for gold in outer space. Flashing some interplanetary gold bling and sipping space water might... Really? This is physics.org tries to go all hip-hop in the first paragraph. Might sound far-fetched, but both could soon be reality thanks to a new U.S. law that legalizes cosmic mining. In a first, President Barack Obama signaled legislation at the end of November that allows commercial extraction of minerals and other materials. This guy is a pisser. We cannot take our own natural resources out of the earth anymore because of climate change, but Obama says we can do it in space.
Well, and not only that, he thinks he's allowed to say what we can do in space.
He ended the space program! This is Obama. Obama, hold on. Just after taking office, this was his speech at NASA.
It's over, Johnny. It's over!
We have the Russians fly us to the space station! This, folks, this is why gun sales have doubled in the last 7 years, because these people are so insane.
They've set records in the last 7 days.
You can't take oil out of the ground where it is, so we have to buy it from who?
Oh, Durka Durka Durka.
Who want what?
Virgin.
He is okay with this. At the end of the space program, but we can get it on the moons. All right, people's cars are telling on each other. Dogs and cats living together. Good God and baby Jesus, what do you think?
No, you missed my favorite story, the burglar getting eaten by the alligator.
Oh, you want to know why? We almost didn't have the time for it. Bah, 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 bah.
Dude running away decides to dive in a lake. His girlfriend reports him missing, and they find him in the body or the belly of an 11-foot alligator.
To make it really simple, Florida, and if you look it out on a map, is actually shaped like it too. Florida, America's colostomy bag. So this idiot goes to rob a bunch of houses with another idiot.
Oh, now you're alienating Florida listeners.
These idiots go to rob a house with another idiot, right? So they're such professional burglars that the people see them, they call the cops, come, helicopter, light, the whole thing. And, you know, they've been to jail before, and they didn't want to go to jail because the last time they went to jail, you know what happened?
Those men wanted to have sex with me.
So this brain dead cracker figures he's going to outsmart the cops and the dogs, hides in the lake, gets eaten by an 11-foot alligator. You know what he can no longer say, Stacey? Baby girl, you got them keys?
Oh, I got them keys.
Let's get out of here.
Absolutely.
Tell the nice people what you'll be doing between now and Thursday.
What am I going to be doing between now and Thursday? I think I'm taking a big old nap.
Between now and Thursday, that's what we call time to fill. Well, folks, mm-hmm. You know where I will be. Barstools, alleyways, city situations, places I shouldn't be, molesting midgets, the occasional donkey show, and wearing a bulletproof vest. If I live through it, I'll see you Thursday night.
I'm looking for you, you Occupy freaks, with your glitter bombs. Bring it on! Bring on the glitter. Everything has changed. Everything has changed in the last few years. Conservatives used to take it, and we're not taking it anymore.
When our water heater broke down last month, it was a nightmare. It took 5 hours for the plumber to show up, and he charged us a couple of $100 just to come out. Then it cost another $1,800 to put in the new water heater. By the time it was all said and done, I felt like I'd been taken. But what else could I do?
The smartest thing you can do is get a home warranty from American Residential Warranty. Their home warranties pay to repair or replace all your major appliances when they break. And they will break, and at the worst possible time. Call American Residential Warranty right now for free information on home warranties starting at just pennies a day. Don't wait for your refrigerator to stop running or your ceiling fans to stop turning. Call American Residential Warranty right now. Ask how you can save up to 50% on washer and dryer coverage. Just call 1-800-513-6154. That's 1-800-513-6154. Again, 1-800-513-6154. Call now.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 $3 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Giggity, 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 let's have sex.